Hey guys, it's Vampire Mike from Sega CD Universe. So I just wanted to do a quick video talking about a film I watched yesterday by Frank Henenlotter, who you may have heard of. He's a really big B director and I guess writer back in the 80s, early 90s, who did Basket Case, Brain Damage, and Frankenhooker, which I think are all really fun, sleazy, kind of over-the-top movies. Lots of gratuitous violence and some gore, very strange, and you can tell he has a lot of imagination when he makes his films. So anyway, one of the movies I hadn't seen that I noticed was online to watch, I want to say it was on Tubi for free, was Bad Biology. So I checked out a little synopsis of it, and I realized it was also co-written and produced by R.A. the Rugged Man, who you may know from being a pretty famous rapper, kind of an underground guy, who is very, very good. I like a couple of his tracks overall in general, but I thought I was kind of interested to see these two collaborate on this. So I put Bad Biology on, and it's primarily focuses on this main girl. Her name in the movie is Jennifer, and she has it, this is the weird part. And all the movies that Frank Henenlotter makes are weird, but this seemed very try hard, for lack of a better term. She has this problem where she's constantly like looking for sex, or she's some sort of a nymphomaniac. She can cross her legs a certain way and orgasm. She's constantly having one night stands, and she's constantly getting pregnant and then giving birth within a couple hours to these like mutant babies, and then just leaving them throughout the city, wherever she is. So it's a very strange concept. The whole thing with babies, there's a couple of things that when people touch upon them in movies, I don't really find them funny. I think they're more in poor taste. That's usually hurting animals and children. So in terms of like her making these CG babies, which are supposed to be like mutated because she has, given birth before they were ready to hatch, so to speak, she's like leaving them in trash cans and abandoning them in like bathtubs and in like seedy hotels and stuff. And it's just kind of off-putting. I'm usually not touchy with things, but in terms of, like I said, animals and children, like a Serbian film I'll never watch. I know what it's about. I've read a thing about it, and I'm good. So I don't need to see that. So anyway, she has like a vagina that has some kind of, they never fully explain it, that unless I missed it. It has like this insatiable urge, and it's almost like a monster to where she just consistently needs to sleep with someone and have sex. She meets eventually, about maybe three quarters of the way through the movie, this other character named Bats. And Bats has a member which is the same way. It's like a monster. It's constantly looking to sleep with someone, and about three quarters of the way through the movie, he gets a hooker and sleeps with her, and she's just not stopping, climaxing for hours. Like she's just laying on the floor because the monster, member he has is just like killed her. So there is some violence in the film. There's a lot of like sex talk and gratuitous dirty language, really perverse imagery, really try hard, if you ask me. I don't think it was sort of like in Brain Damage, they tie in drugs with this like alien thing that's in the guy's neck. In Basket Case, it has this sleazy feeling of this guy with his twin brother that he's, gotten di disattached or from him, and then he's holding in this basket and carrying around. So every movie he has this weirdness to it, but it's creepy. In this, it's not creepy. It's just really dirty and not funny. So she eventually runs into Bats, and I don't really want to spoil it in case you do want to watch it, but I will say I think this is by far the worst Frank Henenlotter film I've seen. I think Basket Case is good, and I really enjoyed all three, but I thought the first one was the best. Brain Damage was really interesting and weird, and Frankenhooker is probably the goofiest kind of funniest out of those three main stays that he's had over the years. This being his sort of comeback film, working with R.A. the Rugged Man, I expected more. It almost seems like it's made by maybe like a kid, to where he's like, oh, I'm gonna come up with these really dumb sexual ideas and be really dirty and perverse, and oh man, his penis is a monster and it crawls away from him and has to find people to sleep with. Like, it's missing that imagination, and that kind of I don't know, dreamlike weirdness that he has in his films. It's just really dirty and stupid, for lack of a better term. I thought some of the acting was pretty bad. There's a lot of Ari the Rugged Man's friends and relatives in the film. So at one point you see Ari the Rugged Man's dad looks and acts exactly like him. Like, you totally could tell it's his father, which was interesting seeing him because he's passed away now. But a lot of his friends are in it that are like, I guess, rappers or wannabe rappers, and they just come off also as these like wannabe like gangsters. Like, I lived in the Bronx for many years when I was a kid, and you always had these people that tried to act tougher than they really were and use slang and accents that weren't theirs. It sort of feels like that. I really didn't like any of the characters. I didn't feel bad for any of the characters. I actually disliked the characters. The only person I sort of liked or felt bad for was the character Bats, because he can't control his Johnson and it's like running amok and acting crazy, and he can't lead a normal life, so you feel kind of bad for him. With the woman, Jennifer, I didn't feel bad for her at all. She just seems like a bad human being, and you know, leaving these children everywhere to die, it wasn't funny. It was just in poor taste. And I know you'll say, well, Mike, his other movies are all in poor taste. You know, in Basket Case, the guy gives oral sex, and the girl gives oral sex to the guy with the weird worm thing. Yeah, okay. And I'm sorry, not Basket Case, Brain Damage, excuse me. I get it. I get that his films are funny and in poor taste, and there's a lot of hookers and Frankenhooker, and he makes them explode and uses their body parts, but it's so weird and out there that it's, you know it's fake. Not to say that obviously people don't have monster vaginas and monster penises, but I guess just the thing with the children and the overtly being like just all bad people, it just didn't do anything for me. I would say if you're a huge fan of his work, give it a watch. Maybe I'm just approaching this a little differently than you will, and maybe you'll enjoy it. But overall, I really didn't like it. So I'm gonna touch base with my buddy Joe, ex Corn Muffin X, because he's a big Frank Henenlotter fan. I want to see what he thinks. I may send him this video too. So let me know what you guys thought of Bad Biology. I didn't like it. It was actually one of my least favorite films this year. It didn't really keep me interested. It sort of just bothered me. Thanks, guys, for watching. It's Vampire Mike from Sega CD Universe. Be good.